actually, again, that recycle that reuse.
Gets, oh, it's Velcro.
It's Velcro, so they can take it off as I tore it off the box.
And
but
it can go back on.
Absolutely. And then, you know, little ABCs, they can put names. There's an eraser
and
on this side. Paper.
So
you know,
do this
it's
stuff.
A shoebox. They love it. This is their box. They know what their box is. So when they want to mm-hmm. play, you know, we had talked about earlier, my mother being a single parent, and in that, you know, two of us would sit down and do homework while she was preparing dinner. Mm-hmm. And then the other three would be setting the table. Okay. So that the chore is getting done and you're getting that individual time. Because as a single parent, when you have multiple children, that individual time is what I hear my clients yeah. tell me a lot about is, I don't feel like I'm giving, or there's one yeah. that may seem favored because I spend more time. Right. Maybe there's a reading issue. So there's ways of being able to split yeah. that time with your children
and
as
I
well.
And I know that they may act like they hate cleaning, and they may hate cleaning, but I will say my kids, they love spending time with me.
Yes.
And even if yes. they don't really like cleaning, I am not lying. When I say, who's going to help me clean the bathrooms?
Hands.
I hear, I'm going to clean the toilets. Let me use the scrubbing thing. I want to use the scrubbing thing. No, me. And they fight over it. They
yes.
want to spend time with me.
Yes.
And
I think
that
too,
is a greater motivator than
make
anything
it
else.
Fun. It yes. doesn't have to be a chore. Mm-hmm. That's the whole premise behind it
yeah.
is, again, when
well,
you
and
set
then we're
that
training
up.
Training them too. You know, mm-hmm. so they actually know how to clean their own house when they get out.
When
they can be the only dorm room
and
that's clean.
That's exactly
how
it. And they're not bringing their laundry
then
home.
All the other moms will be jealous because they're like, my daughter's dorm room is not as clean. Well, and then you can just do like this and say, mm-hmm. oh, that's how we
it was years
roll.
Of practice and years of training.
Yes.
We created that individual.
Yeah.
So
that's exciting. Okay. So the structures, we went over plenty. Oh, and
yes.
one more note about the structures is one other thing that I made was I made a list of like specifically what it means to clean a bathroom.
Yes.
And then
especially
laminate
when
them
you're teaching
and
someone.
Post them mm-hmm. somewhere.
Well, think
or
about
put
the
them
jobs
with the
you have.
Stuff.
If you've ever
yeah.
had a job, you know, my first job was at the Dairy Queen. There were laminated lists on how to clean all
yeah.
that equipment. I'm
that
not going to
true.
Remember it until
I
years and years
of, that.
Of practice. So going back to how you learn when you're working
yeah.
or being in the workforce, so being able to do that, you know, they are, again, children are little people. They are going to follow your lead.
Yeah.
So if you're leading, and, you know, one of the biggest things I have with clients is cleaning up before you go to bed. That's
yeah.
huge.
Yes, again, surrounding that, around a dinner time.
Absolutely.
Everyone knows, right after dinner, don't go off yet.
No,
take
we have to take the dishes.
And just make it happen.
Because
yeah.
when your house is chaotic, it actually psychologically affects you.
Yeah.
So that's very important to keep in mind, that a lot of these things mm-hmm. we think are just uncleanly or unkept, or, you know, I'm a little crazy because you could probably eat off the floors of my house. I don't have children yet. So
just
you know,
wait.
That's exactly
we're going to put a hidden camera in her house when she has kids.
That my family will probably do that experiment, be honest with you.
That's
but
funny.
Being able to set that up where when you go to bed, when you wake up in the morning, that chaos isn't staring you in the face to start a new day. So you're starting the new day with a clean slate, and who knows what will happen by the end of it.
Very cool. Okay, so we have about 5 minutes left, so
okay.
we want to move on to those. So the maintenance is really what we wrapped up in talking about this.
Yes.
And so, and everything comes down to routines. And there's a list that we'll talk about how to remember to do all the something you do every three months.
Every 3 months,
all
every
that
month.
Will be on the Facebook page, so make sure to check that out.
Absolutely.
So now that we've talked about the organizing, the maintenance, the cleaning,
mm-hmm.
now let's talk about the fun stuff.
Yes.
How can, now that we've kind of gotten the chaos under control and the clutter belted down,
mm-hmm.
how can we really make this space our own? It's working for us
simple
now.
Simple things, absolutely simple things. Once you get a design plan
mm-hmm.
or a color scheme or learning where, you know, what pieces will you need to replace more
okay,
often.
Okay, I'm going to send it back up. You said design plan and you kind of lost me.
Okay.
So let's pretend I didn't even know what the word design meant. Let's just say how we can make this space reflect someone, like simple as like, How can we say that?
Well, truthfully, I think the easiest way to say that is when you're looking at it, is your space going to multifunction or
uh-huh.
is it a living room or does it / dining room or
mm-hmm.
is it / working room? So being able to find out what that space actually is
mm-hmm.
and then being able to say, okay, well, we have a table that can double as a desk
oh.
and being able to use pieces multiple. I'm always about using and having two or three functions for pieces.
Mm-hmm.
Simple things for like the kids, you know, we're all on a budget. I've
right.
worked with people from no budget all the way up to unlimited budget. you know, these two canvas pieces come together. Oh. So you can do these as a, there you go, can you see that? Mm-hmm. You know, just, I just penciled out, these were just drawn on with pencil, then I just mark a cover, then they're beautiful. I love orange. That orange is so a verbally attractive color. And this is simple dollar ribbon. Hot glue.
That's awesome.
Cut it, weave it's it so in and simple. Out, whatever
None of
you
us
would
have
like
ever
to do.
Thought of it.
Well, that's it. Sometimes you try to make the complicated.
So
you make
hard.
It so overcomplicated. Again, this was just
this
a piece
is
of fabric.
Glued.
This is just fabric glued on the back. You can staple it on the back. These are actually pre-cut squares for a dollar at Walmart. Any
store.
Color. Absolutely. Little bit of ribbon.
Yeah,
and
the thrift stores have bins and
yes.
bins of fabric. And they'll have just like little pieces. You're like, you
yes.
can't use that for anything.
No.
Yes,
and the only
can.
Thing is like projects like this, your children can pick them out. They can decorate them. They can help you with
oh.
them. I just caution you with the
that
hot
canvas.
Glue gun. No, this is just raw
And so
canvas.
Everyone who thinks, oh, I'm not creative, I cannot do anything in my house.
This took me
well,
six and a half minutes.
You can do a lot in your
Absolutely.
House. You can.
And you can, and a thumbtack, you know,
yeah.
a thumbtack on the wall or,
a thumbtack
you know,
works.
Velcro.
You don't even have to have a hammer.
No. You push it into the wall, the kids can help you.
That's great.
They can put it up wherever they need to.
My son would use a hammer
to.
For things he shouldn't, mm-hmm. like banging a hole
And
in
again,
the wall.
Things like, you know, contact paper. This is a box of buttons.
Oh, that's
we
so cute.
We all lose them. A jelly jar, you consume
Looks
the product.
Looks like something on that magazine that talks about organization.
Yes,
the whatever.
I think it's Creative Living.
Something,
or,
mm-hmm. I don't know. I don't think we're supposed
Real
to say
simple.
It on the air.
And then just contact paper, and then you can label it.
That's
you know,
so
the
great.
Kids can write on this, and you can always take it off, toss it out, pull
just
it off.
Just simple touches.
Just simple little things mm-hmm. that, and who hasn't lost buttons before? And then
That's
this
great.
Is all
so
right there for you.
So you can just set these
you.
Things around. And then, of course, probably one of the other cheapest things that you can do, if you can't do anything else, paint the walls.
Paint
and
the walls.
And if you don't know what colors,
relatively
you can go online and research all that.
Well, a lot of the paint manufacturers now are asking.
And they have those caps.
They are
yes.
having the little baby samples.
You have about 30 seconds.
So you can go ahead and just paint little samples. Also, you know, at Lowe's, Home Depot, mm-hmm. any of the home improvement stores, you can
They'll
get
help you out.
The 1x2 boards and fabric wrap that and lean
oh
it against
goodness.
The wall. And it's artwork.
That's so exciting. I wish we could be here all day, but we can't.
I can talk about it forever.
We do have to go, though, for real. And thank you so much
you
for being
so
here with
welcome.
Us. I had
I
so much fun.
It.
Thank you for joining us, everyone. I really enjoyed it, and have a wonderful day. Remember that you are not alone.